What's happening is we were thinking about team names, like if you had a name for a team.
I thought the Moccasins.
The Moccasins.
Which I quite like, but then I thought we could soup it up. We could be the Electric Moccasins. Sound like a psychedelic
cool
band.
Cool names for bands just trip off your tongue, don't they? The Electric Moccasins.
Yeah, the Electric Moccasins.
Or Robson and Jerome.
Which one are you?
Well, Jerome.
Richard and Noel, have you got a team name?
The Indoor Kites.
Imagine how indoor kites work as well. I mean, what propels them? I imagine it's jealousy. Or rage.
Or just hot shame.
Hot shame.
Hot shame's another
Maybe
good name
what
for
about
a band.
Hot shame.
Hot, can we be hot shame?
Hot shame.
Hot shame. Okay. They played 183 games. It took 11 hours and 5 minutes.
They look like a tennis ventriloquist act, don't they?
Okay, Alan and Michael, did you?
The longest tennis match.
Longest match, right. Pretty good. Okay, yeah. And you went with Noel and Richard?
He'd just had sexy times.
Is that what it's called in your house?
Yeah, 6 o'clock to 6:15. So we just put an egg timer out.
Okay, Nicole Scherzinger wanted to know which items Gordon Brown allegedly threw at his colleagues. What did you all put?
Mobile phone and then a pen.
OK, lovely. Jonathan and Ruth, you've gone for...?
I thought maybe a shoe. Ruth thought a telephone.
Mm. OK, and Noel and Richard, you've gone with...?
Satsuma, live wasp and nightmares.
Let's go over to Nicole Scherzinger and find out what the real answer was.
Did you get it? Gordon Brown allegedly threw a mobile phone, a stapler and... a laser printer at colleagues while he was prime minister.
Jimmy, if she had actually said either Satsuma, wasp or nightmare, it would have been the greatest moment of all our lives.
She said he threw a da-da-da at someone.
Which I believe is a slang for Satsuma wasp.
Yeah. How can you throw a live wasp? A dead wasp, I get that.
Well, you pretend you're throwing it, but you're in cahoots with a wasp, right. And you go, in a minute, when I release you, just fly straight towards his head. And then it goes off.
So it looks like you're throwing it.
Yeah, but really...
it's flying.
Yeah.
Why do you think it's weirder throwing a live wasp than a nightmare?
Well, it's easier to catch criminals when it's snowing, in fairness to them, because they've got the prints. They can just go, there's been a break-in, we'll just follow those.
Not sort of tax dodging, though.
No. White collar crime.
Yeah.
Intellectual property crime. What about that, Jimmy? I mean, you haven't thought this through. It's really.
I showed you some pictures of broken TVs. What do you think caused the damage?
Erections.
That's just silly.
That's why I ceiling mount my TV.
Okay, Sarah. Okay, what did you go for, Jonathan? Ruth? What did you go for?
Hitler.
Have the whole range. They were angry on polling day because they couldn't find a poll.
They couldn't find a poll. No. Noel and Richard have probably got it. Okay, 600 people in Chester. 200 people in Sheffield, 150 people in Hackney.
Angry because they got bitten by a horse. The same horse, Jimmy. That horse was busy that day.
Biting and galloping around.
Okay, well, let's see what you got, okay?
He's a film director.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Toy Story 3, Alice in Wonderland, Kick-Ass, they've got absolutely right. As have Alan and Michael and Jonathan and Ruth, okay. But I'm much more impressed with you. Well done.
I'm going to leave now.
Leave on a high.
Not even joking.
Just fashions from music stars in the 90s. I did once wear a pair of MC Hammer trousers. It was dark and I didn't want to weigh MC Hammer, so I picked up the wrong pair. Isn't that joke, fuck MC Hammer. Right.
Did he say you can't touch that?
Yeah. Well, I can't touch this. It'd be a different song if it was you can't touch that.
a whole different song.
Can I just say...
That's a yet more conversion of it.
That is the most anal heckle I've ever had.
That is a very different area to this.
You can't, can't touch this. Or you
that.
Can't touch that.
Yeah.
It's not a massive difference, is it?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
It's well, it is. That as opposed to this. This you cannot touch. That, free country.
If it had been Lancashire, then you can't touch anything. Hey, don't touch out. Don't touch out. Don't touch out.
See, touching out again.
It's a marvellous. Okay. Time for some more questions. Who managed to set a new world record after spending 71 days crying in the B&Q? Richard and Noel, what have you put as your answer to this question?
Your mum.
Was it your mum? No, seriously, was it your mum?
I feel like a supply teacher at a rough school.
Sir, it
Stop
was so your mum.
Girl in your head, and look at the card. Does it say your mum? No, seriously though, is it your mum?
I saw your mum in B&Q, sir. By the garden furniture.
She's like bawling her eyes out by the garden furniture.
No, sir. I did see her.
It's your mum.
She was by the garden
that
furniture.
That was your mum.
She's getting the real cheap shit as well.
That was your mum, yeah.
They're really mean to me. They're bullying me. I don't like it.
It was your mum, though.
So when's Mr. Rogers back? Because he's like a good teacher.
Mr. Rogers isn't coming back. He's dead.
Did your mum kill him? I heard your mum killed him during sex.
Andy Peters asked you what Anthea Turner did on Blue Peter to prompt 100,000 people to write to the BBC. Did anyone get this?
She denied the Holocaust.
Again. Jimmy, on a lighter note, I once stayed at Anthea Turner's house and I took the bath panel off and hid under the bath. Just saying.
How are you doing, Richard? You all right?
I don't know. I've drifted off a bit, to be honest. But.
I didn't.
Didn't it? Generally. Well,
do you think good, they ate just checking in. Just
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Now, I tell you what, actually, it's very hard in our place to get the cold water pressure up. Do you know what I mean? In the shower, and that's it's just a nightmare. On that, it's fine. You know, as in, it's very hot, the shower, and we actually have to run the hot water just to, you know, take the edge off.
This isn't for what you lot. This is just the
just checking in with how Richard's doing. Apparently, the cold water pressure, not great, but we'll try and... I guess we'll just have to, you know, soldier on.
Sorry, I just made the mistake of genuinely responding to your question, which I thought was... I thought that was an inquiry.
I always imagined you as a bath man. You have showers?
Are you high up? Is your flat high up?
It is, but the cold water, it can't reach high enough.
Well, the cold water might be in a tank above, even.
We don't have a tank. I took the tank out. That might be the problem. I took the tank out.
Why would you take the tank out?
Because I wanted to put a big bean bag.
Rather than a water tank?
Yeah.
Can you not get a plumber?
This is what I was looking for. I can get a plumber, but I want a reliable one, Ruth.
Get a Welsh one. Get a Welsh one.
I live in London.
No.
I have a plumber. I have a plumber for you.
Has anyone got any clue what we're meant to be doing at this time?
We were just about to solve it.
Richard, I have a plumber. He's got his own plumber.
OK, time for another say what you see question. There will be some pictures. You will say what you see. No one will talk about baths or showers. No one.
Yeah, they had a court case.
They had a court case because you don't get VAT on cakes and you do on chocolate biscuits.
Don't talk to me about tax,
and
baby.
The customs.
I've got my own problems.
Well, no, but it's actually true. It's legally a cake and it doesn't attract VAT.
Can you make yourself legally a cake?
I think possibly if I get myself filled with cream, yeah.
Is that what your accountant makes you do? If you say that, Jimmy, the nation will forgive you.
No, I just heard you say, why are we even bothering? Because you could win this. You know you could. Come on.
Jimmy, what are the current scores?
I'll do the scores in a minute.
No, we'll Jimmy, don't fob me off. What are the current scores?
11, 13, 4.
OK, so we might as well go.
No, you can make it up.
How?
Because there's a massive question that is worth 15 points at the end.
Really? Are you being
genuine?
Serious?
No, genuinely.
True? Okay.
Is that true?
Jimmy, that's genuinely true.
Jimmy, is that really Jimmy, don't
true?
Lie to me.
I'm not lying to you.
Jimmy. Is that true?
Genuinely
do
true.
Not lie to me.
I will not lie to you.
Jimmy, is that true? I'll give you this eye patch if that's true.
That is true.
You probably look good in an eye patch.
I'll see. I have a feeling I will look like a baddie from Captain Scarlet. I imagine it's going to suit me now. Does that? Mr. Bond, who's been expecting you?
Right, before I ask the questions for the final round, just to rack up the tension on the Big Fat Quiz of the 90s, I'm going to tell you we've got a gunge tank for the losers. We've got the actual Noel's House Party gunge tank.
No.
Well, can we just lower the tension a bit by saying, go fuck yourself?
Richard looks thrilled. You look super excited about this. We've got a gunge tank and you're behind, so buck up your ideas.
I will kill you in your sleep.